So here's a question that has divided nutritionists and health professionals over the years. What is better, roti or rice? Which one should you have for weight loss? If you also have these questions, watch this video till the end. Hello everyone, this is Nirupama and welcome to Simplify. I make videos on food, health and nutrition. First and foremost, let's look at the macronutrients in roti and in rice. In terms of total calories, two medium rotis have about 220 calories, which is quite similar to what is found in one serving or one bowl of white rice, which is 210 calories. Two rotis have about 6 to 7 grams of protein, while one bowl of white rice has about 4.5 grams of protein. Amount of fat is quite negligible in both roti and in rice. The major difference lies in the amount and type of carbohydrates in these two. Two rotis have about 36 grams of complex carbohydrates. The carbohydrates in roti are called complex carbs because roti is made out of atta, and atta is made by grinding the whole grain of wheat. This is also the reason rotis have more fiber. Two rotis have about 8 grams of fiber. White rice has about 45 grams of simple carbohydrates. White rice is made by polishing and removing the outer skin of the grain of rice. This is also the reason white rice has negligible amount of fiber. In terms of micronutrients, rotis will provide you calcium, iron, potassium, phosphorus and other micronutrients. White rice, on the other hand, has very low levels of calcium, potassium and phosphorus. Because rotis are made out of whole grain of wheat, they will provide you more micronutrients than white rice. Now let's look at the glycemic index of rotis and rice and how they affect our blood sugar and blood insulin. A food is said to have a higher glycemic index when it rapidly increases our blood sugar and blood insulin levels, and such foods shouldn't be overconsumed. Now, since rotis have more fiber in them, they have a lower glycemic index. White rice, on the other hand, has a higher glycemic index and it does spike our blood sugar and blood insulin levels. So on paper, it does look like rotis are a more preferable option than white rice. Rotis have more fiber, more protein, more micronutrients and a lower glycemic index. But are rotis actually a healthier option than rice? Not really. I feel like rice has got so much bad publicity in the media over the years, and there are so many things about rice that we don't know or we overlook. Like for instance, even though rice has less protein than wheat, the quality of protein and amino acids in rice is much better than that found in wheat. In fact, studies have shown that a combination of rice and pulses or legumes provides a complete amino acid profile that is comparable to what is found in dairy or in eggs. One such example where rice and dal come beautifully together is our very own Indian dish called khichdi. Rice has something called resistant starch, which is now proven to act as a prebiotic in our body. So eating rice is actually good for the friendly bacteria in our gut. Rice hardly has any fiber and we are often scared that it will increase our blood sugar levels. But rice is never ever eaten just by itself. In India, we combine rice with dals or pulses and with vegetables. And there is a lot of fiber in dals and vegetables that slows down the release of sugar from rice. So there you go. The high glycemic index of rice can be counteracted by combining rice with dals, pulses and vegetables. Rice is much easier on the stomach and it is easier to digest than rotis. Therefore, rice is recommended to us when we have an upset stomach, and that is also the reason rice is recommended to babies and toddlers. Let's talk about varieties of rice. There are incredible varieties of rice in India, right from red rice, black rice, hand-pound rice, semi-polished rice, parboiled rice. So you don't have to stick to just white rice. You can experiment with different varieties of rice. So eating roti and rice both have their own benefits. Roti has more fiber, more protein, more micronutrients, while rice has better quality protein and resistant starch in it. So what is the takeaway? What should you really eat? It is okay to eat either rice or roti based on your preference. Both rice and roti are high calorific foods, which means that they are heavy in calories, and both can cause weight gain when overeaten or consumed in excess. So quantity and portion control is important with both rice and roti. You shouldn't overeat both of them. If you are worried about the high glycemic index of rice, try including more of hand-pound rice or semi-polished rice in your diet. when you are eating rice, make sure to combine it with dals and pulses, some good fats like ghee and vegetables. If you are someone who's watching out the level of sodium in diet, watch out how many rotis you eat, because rotis and wheat have a good amount of sodium in them. It is very important to incorporate a good variety of grains and pulses in your diet. So have rice sometimes, have roti the other times, and also include millets in your diet from time to time. In fact, I will be making a video on how to incorporate millets in your diet. Watch out for that one. That's all for me today. I hope this video was insightful for you guys. If you haven't already subscribed to my channel, you can do so by hitting the red subscribe button and hit the bell icon next to it so that you get notified whenever I upload a video. Thanks so much for watching the video. I'll see you guys next time. Take care until then. Bye.